All right, guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is Jose. I'm an air traffic controller slash aviation flight sim VR nerd geek here. And this is going to be some update six. I'm going to take you guys along for this really short flight here, just about 5 minutes. In fact, I had to do a voiceover just because the quality on the audio got a little bit weird with my headset. I think I actually left my mic recording over here on my desk, which is next to my sim pit. But anyways, guys, sim update six. And earlier today, I was able to fly again, like I said, for maybe about 5, 6, 7 minutes. I flew into Miami in the Airbus 320, not the fly-by-wire one, but just the regular one. And I came out the other side. I did a missed approach, came back again for runway 30. And again, I like to fly into densely populated cities to kind of stress the system. And it flew great. It was really smooth. It was a great experience. There was no issues. Now, everyone online is having a lot of issues. Microsoft has said that they have acknowledged the fact that there are server issues. Servers are down. People on the forums are talking about it on Facebook, on Twitter. It's kind of all over the place. I will tell you this. I have actually noticed some good improvements as far as anti-aliasing, some lighting issues as far as lights emitted from aircraft. I haven't quite noticed that the huge brightness in VR is gone. Actually, right here, let's take a note real fast. It says authentication to online services succeeded. Online services access are restored or is restored. And I'll tell you what. So I was kind of curious because right now online, I'm actually flying offline. So that sounded weird. I'm actually flying offline in this flight here. And my thought was, okay, if I'm offline, what can I do that would still be enjoyable? And my thought was to fly during a sunrise or sunset and throw some nice, this is just basically the standard scattered clouds, and the lighting is just amazing. I mean, the sim looks good. I'm currently right here by, what is it, South Beach. The island right beneath me is actually Fisher Island. I'm right next to the Port of Miami, downtown Miami, and then down to the top left of the screen over there is Virginia Key. You'll see down in the bottom, actually scenery will load even if you're offline. So if you pay for Latin VFR scenery like I have, it's going to load in just fine. So that custom scenery, custom airports will still be there, but everything else is going to be generic. Now the clouds and everything, the lighting looked amazing. Now here you can see me, I'm slewing north because my thought was, okay, it says I'm online. What if I slew north? Is it going to start updating and loading the updated scenery? So I hang around for a few minutes only to find out that it does not. It does not update the online proper Azure AI custom scenery. It's really blind. It just does the standard generic offline stuff, even though it just said I was online. So that was a bit of a bummer. Again, I'm not the only person here struggling with these issues. You know, I'm not really exempt from this. We're all kind of in this together. I think Microsoft so far, they're doing a pretty good job. There's obviously some bugs, some kinks in the line here that they're having to work through, even though my first experience was really awesome. But yeah, so I don't know. I don't know what else to say. You know, we're kind of just going to have to wait for them. I can't really give it a you know, overall fair assessment or review. It's been really good, really bad. Again, there's been some cool improvements, some things that I'm really excited about. The clarity, in fact, the clarity overall felt a lot better. The performance also felt better. So that was really cool. We do have the slider that gets to push out the terrain, or is it the draw distance out to like 400, which was really nice, kind of doubling it from before. And I'm not sure I saw an FPS hit, but I do have a 3090, but I did hear other folks talking about that they have, you know, either moderate, you know, GPUs and they didn't notice an FPS hit. So kind of interesting. Let me know how it's performing for you, but I'm going to have to wait for things to improve to really give this a fair assessment and let you know what I think about it. But if anything comes up, I'll let you guys know. Just follow me on either Twitter or Discord or the Facebook group, whatever. That way, you know, we can just talk a little bit more about it and share, you know, our experiences or any solutions we might find along the way. But yeah, anyways, guys, a really short video here. I'm kind of bummed out. I just got home from work and I was really hoping to fly and enjoy it a bit. I will say this, if you are offline, the best thing you could do is fly at night, you know, or fly early in the morning or at dawn or dusk. Can't see the terrain really, so does it matter? I mean, the lighting is nice. You can navigate via highways and you know, VFR just fall on certain roads, and it's just a different experience. If you don't fly a lot at night, when you're offline, it's the best time to fly because you're not going to notice that the potato ugly textures on the terrain and the generic random buildings, which are, you know, cookie cut and paste everywhere. So anyways, guys, thanks for watching. If you have any questions, just leave them below. I'll have an update as soon as things improve. But for now, we're just going to have to wait on Microsoft and see what they do. But anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and hope you guys are doing well. Let me know in the comments below how it's been for you. Later. Bye.